Riboflavin, or vitamin B2, is the ultimate fat-burning nutrient. This is how to know if you need more of it. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about signs that you could need more riboflavin. The first sign that you need more riboflavin is an iron deficiency anemia that doesn't respond well to iron. In other words, your serum iron levels are low, your complete blood count looks like you have anemia, and you keep putting iron supplements into your body, or you keep putting iron-rich foods into your body, your iron doesn't go anywhere, your anemia doesn't go anywhere. It could be that you have an underlying poor riboflavin status, and you don't have enough riboflavin to help you utilize the iron properly. The second sign you might see is elevated homocysteine. You could see elevated homocysteine because of an underlying poor riboflavin status, regardless of your genetics, but you are especially likely to see this if you have low MTHFR activity. MTHFR is an enzyme that uses folate to make methylfolate, and methylfolate helps you clear homocysteine. But the MTHFR enzyme depends on riboflavin, and people with low MTHFR activity have low MTHFR activity because that their enzyme happens to need more riboflavin than the average person's enzyme in order to make it work properly. So if your riboflavin status is very poor, you might have elevated homocysteine regardless of your genetics. But if your riboflavin status is just mediocre and kind of in the middle, you might not see the elevated homocysteine if you don't have low MTHFR activity. And if you do have low MTHFR activity, that's where you might see the elevated homocysteine, even on mediocre riboflavin status. Some other things that you might see are cataracts, high blood pressure, oxidative stress, which could manifest as wear and tear on your tissues, and what seems to be faster aging than you would expect, migraines, fatigue, exercise intolerance. In pregnancy, preeclampsia might largely be driven by poor riboflavin status. Finally, because we use almost twice as much riboflavin to burn fat for fuel as we do when we burn carbohydrate for fuel, then a general sense of better health and well-being on a low-fat diet, or a general sense of poor health and well-being when on a high-fat diet, could be signs that you need more riboflavin. When riboflavin deficiency gets really bad, it causes a characteristic set of signs that constitute the textbook appearance or manifestation of classical riboflavin deficiency. If it gets that bad, you would expect to see some of the following things: a red, crusty, greasy, inflamed skin that would occur on the outer edges of your mouth, cracks and fissures at the corners of your mouth. You'd see the inflammation on the outer edges of your nose, your eyelids, your smile lines, and your genitals. You would get redness, bleeding, and swelling in your tongue and all inside your mouth. You could get hypersensitivity to touch and to pain and to heat in your hands and feet. You could get conjunctivitis, and you could get a specific manifestation of anemia that, even though iron deficiency anemia can be a problem with riboflavin deficiency, you can also get a much more specific riboflavin deficiency anemia where the red blood cell levels are low and yet the hemoglobin and the red blood cell size is normal. If any of these things, from the signs of more common suboptimal status or to the signs of the severe classical deficiency, if any of those things apply to you, then it'll be especially important to check out the next few episodes, because there I'll be talking about all the different things that we can do to optimize our riboflavin status. This episode is brought to you by Vitamins and Minerals 101. This is my new free 30-day course providing one lesson a day on each nutrient delivered straight to your inbox. It can go to your email or it can go to your Facebook Messenger. If you get the Messenger version, it's taught by Chris Masterbot, my baby bot. It's more interactive. There are more emojis and there are more jokes. But both email and Facebook Messenger are incredibly educational. Each lesson covers why the nutrient is important to your health, how to know if you have too little or too much or the wrong balance with other nutrients, how to get it from food, and when you should think about supplementing. It is not a technical or advanced course. It is completely minimum in its technical jargon, and it is designed for the beginner with no background in nutrition and no background beyond high school in the basic sciences. Nevertheless, many people who have backgrounds in nutrition are saying that it is an amazing refresher course full of nuggets of valuable information in each lesson. Sign up completely free by Facebook Messenger or by email at chrismasterjohnphd.com/101. This episode is brought to you by Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. This is my recipe to empower you to banish any deficiency or nutritional imbalance from your body. I've been through the pain of my teeth falling apart, my stomach being in constant pain, and my OCD going off the rails during my stint with veganism, to the point where panic attacks were the norm and I was afraid to eat any of the food in my house. I've been through the path of healing using nutrient-dense animal foods to nourish all the systems of my body and become a new person. But I've also learned that my needs change over time. The red meat and liver that were so healing in my recovery from veganism later started sapping my energy and brain power, only to find out that I'm genetically predisposed to iron overload and need to manage it with blood donations. And I've learned from friends, colleagues, and clients that everyone is different. Your needs are not mine. Mine aren't what they were 10 years ago. Yours won't be what they are now in 10 years. That's why we need a precise recipe to know exactly what's missing, exactly what's overloaded, exactly what's imbalanced, and an action plan to fix things, and a way to measure our success. That's what I've done with Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet. Get your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet and use the code LITE20, that's LITE and the number 20, LITE20 to get 20% off. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read, and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.